Everyone's looking for information about COVID-19, what to do to keep safe, to prevent you and your family members from getting sick. So many people turn to the internet. And a quick search does turn up lots of real answers from, you know, public health authorities. Keep your distance, wash your hands for the 20 seconds. But online, there's also a whole minefield of quackery and misinformation. So Katie Nicholson, part of our COVID fact-checking team, is taking a closer look this morning at some of the most common myths and viral videos that could trip you up.
There's a lot of myths out there about COVID-19, and we're fact-checking them for you.
Myth one, lemon juice can treat COVID-19.
Slices of lemon in a cup of hot water can save your life.
The lemon juice myth has circulated on multiple platforms and has been seen by millions. Typically, it quotes Chinese medical experts.
If you Google one of the names of the so-called experts, it can translate from Mandarin to English, what is your name? So the experts are fictitious and the advice isn't much better.
Nope, not at all. Not a cure. Don't think that eating lemons is going to protect you in any way. Lemons are not the cure.
Myth two, steam or heat can treat the virus. There are many variations of this myth.
This is classic misinformation because there's a kernel of truth in here. It is true that high temperatures can kill some germs, but while a virus is replicating in your body, that's just a lot of hot air.
The virus is not just waiting in your nostrils, it's further down your airways, it has entered your cells, it's replicating inside your cells, and you can actually damage your skin, so you can actually hurt yourself doing this.
Myth three, you can make your own N95 mask.
Natural materials like cotton and wool naturally repel viruses. I had to find that out on the internet, but I did.
So first of all, the N95 respirator is a specially designed medical grade mask, and it has to be fitted by experts.
You can't make an N95 out of a bra. You know, N95s filter out at least 95% of particles that are smaller than, I think it's 0.3 microns. And the fabric that's used in them, the very specific mesh, is very difficult to make. It's not something you can just make from home.
While some countries and health authorities advocate wearing homemade masks, even if you are wearing a mask, you still have to follow all the other public health rules.
Myth four, the breath test. This is a popular post allegedly from a friend who works at the CDC, and it claims if you can hold your breath for more than 10 seconds, you are COVID-19 free.
So if it were that simple, we wouldn't be hearing on the news day in, day out that we are running out of test kits for COVID-19.
And it turns out holding your breath doesn't prove anything.
Well, a lot of people are asymptomatic with COVID or they have very minor symptoms. So this idea that, oh, if I could hold my breath, it would tell me, well, no, that we don't have any way to tell you without doing a test.
Myth five, the rituals. Someone may have forwarded you this message. It's a list of things you can do to keep the coronavirus at bay. It claims drinking warm water every 20 minutes or gargling with salt water will protect you.
This idea that, you know, water or gargling can help is absolutely not true. But I can see when there's so much uncertainty, how something that's almost a bit ritualistic, feel like a ritual, could make people feel comfortable. And the problem is when there's nothing to do except hand washing and stay inside, that people look for something concrete to do.
Comforting as these rituals may be, this list, like all those other posts, is false. Katie Nicholson, CBC News, Toronto.
To remind you, if you want to get to the heart of things, get to the truth and figure out fact from fiction, this is where you can send a question or a tip. Our team at COVID@cbc.ca.